Hello and salam, friends. We can change default interface colors. We can change scroll bar color. Customize UI elements in Photoshop. And wherever we want to change colors, we can customize whole Adobe Photoshop. I have done with some areas to show you how we can customize these colors. Let's get started. These are default colors of Photoshop. Go to Edit, Preferences, Interface. You can see color theme. There are four colors in theme. One is black, second is gray, third is light gray and fourth is white. Keep these four colors in mind. Photoshop has these four colors in theme. First black, second gray, third light gray, fourth white. Open File Explorer. Click on C drive. Open folder for program files. You can see folder for Adobe. Open it and you can see folder for Adobe Photoshop 2021. Open it then open required folder. Scroll down and find a file UI colors. All colors for Photoshop are coded in this file. Do not change until you have a duplicate file. So you can set back to original colors. Right click on this file and click on copy. Again right click and paste this file. It needs administrator permission to copy this file. Click on continue. There is a copy file for UI color, copy. I will rename this file UI colors original. It will ask administrator permission again. Click on continue. Now we will use UI colors file to customize colors of Photoshop. I will change colors of scroll bar. Just want to show you how we can customize. You need Notepad++ for it? Right click on file and edit with Notepad++. These are all colors for Photoshop interface. First color is for white theme. Second color is for light gray. Third is for gray color and fourth is for black theme. I have selected gray color theme. So I will change interface colors for third theme. Here I want to tell about three values. These first three values are for RGB. I mean red, green, and blue. Fourth one is alpha value. It is for luminance. Here 1.0 mean 100% opacity. If it is 0.5 then it's mean 50% opacity. I think concept is clear for these four values. First three values are red, green, and blue. And the last one is for opacity. Again, 1.0 mean 100% opacity. and 0.5 mean 50% opacity. Suppose I want to change colors of scroll bar. It is a long list in Notepad++. And it's difficult to find scroll bar colors. Click on Search, Find. I will write scroll bar in Find What. Click on Find Next. It will jump to first scroll bar. Click again to find next. Until you find widget scroll bar elevator fill. I need to change it. This third one is Photoshop color theme. I need to change it. Go to a website to pick RGB colors. This site is for color picker. This is site is coolers.co. You can select any color by your own choice. Suppose I am going to pick this blue color. Here are its RGB values. Scroll down and you can see shades, tints and shades. But we need RGB values of color we chose. Click on this icon to copy these values. This is my widget scroll bar elevator fill. Select first three values. And press Ctrl+V to paste that blue color values. Click on Save and it will ask for administrator permission. Click on Yes. Click on Save second time and close Notepad++. Now, we will close Photoshop. And reopen it. Click on same picture we were working. You can see colors of scroll bar become blue. It is same blue color we copied from coolers.co. Remember this site or bookmark this site. We can get RGB values for any color from this site. So, this is way we can customize Photoshop interface colors. Suppose we want to set Photoshop as default colors theme. Close Photoshop and delete UI color file. It will ask administrator permission. So click on continue and file has been deleted. Rename UI colors original to UI colors. Click on continue. This is your original file with default color codes. Open Photoshop and watch it is set to its default colors theme. I mean it original colors theme. So, if you want to customize interface colors of Photoshop, you can customize in this way. This is topic for today. How to customize interface colors of Photoshop. This is video for today. If you like video then like and subscribe. Thanks for watching. Till next, Allah Hafiz.